In this lecture, we will be addressing the concept of territorial sovereignty and what it means under international law. In doing this, we will be addressing four questions. What is sovereignty? What is territorial sovereignty? What is the source of this concept? And what consequence does this carry under international law? To the question, what is sovereignty? In its basic form, sovereignty is the unbridled right and power of a governing body over itself. It embodies rights and powers devoid of any interference from outside sources or bodies. It is a state of supreme authority. Historically, the concept has been used in three main ways. Subject of sovereignty, and this is a reference to function or person. Nature of sovereignty, this is reference to the scope, limited or absolute. And source of sovereignty, reference to where the sovereignty is derived from the law or outside the law. In this lecture, our focus will be on the nature and source of sovereignty. Under international law, sovereignty is a very important concept and a founding principle. Here, it infers the exercise of power by a state. And when we conceptualize this power under international law, it can exist as de jure, in which case it constitutes a legitimate or legal right to exercise power over a state, and or exists de facto, in which case it refers to the factual existence of power by a state. And so theoretically speaking, de jure and de facto sovereignty ought to exist simultaneously in a stable and internationally recognized state. But in reality, either of these situations may exist in isolation in political units. This is at the moment beyond the scope of this lecture, and we'll attempt to explore this in one of our subsequent lessons. However, a combination of these theoretical situations can happen for several reasons, perhaps in a bid for self-determination, but whatever the situation, it does have consequences for statehood and recognition. So both concepts of statehood and recognition we will discuss in a subsequent video.
What is territorial sovereignty?
Territorial sovereignty or integrity is a cornerstone principle under international law that prohibits states from the use of force against the territorial integrity or political independence of another state. Such use of force or imposition on a state's sovereignty is generally deemed an act of aggression. Suffice to say that recent developments in international law has seen tensions rise between the principle of territorial sovereignty and the concept of humanitarian intervention. The concept of humanitarian intervention we will explore in a subsequent video. One can say, therefore, that in characteristics, sovereignty is immutably absolute, complete, and unchallengeable. Source of territorial sovereignty. Within the international normative order, the Statute of the United Nations is always a place to start in tracing source, meaning, and context. Regarding the concept of territorial sovereignty, a combined reading of Article 2, 4, and 2, sub 7 of the United Nations Charter would be a place to look. So while Article 2, 4 enshrines an avowed principle of customary international law, which is the non-use of force between states, it explicitly states that all members shall refrain in their international relations from the threat or use of force against the territorial integrity or political independence of any state, or in any other manner inconsistent with the purposes of the United Nations. On the other hand, Article 2.7 addresses the United Nations and precludes the UN's intervention in matters within the sovereign preserve of nation states. Specifically, it states, nothing contained in the present charter shall authorize the United Nations to intervene in matters which are essentially within the domestic jurisdiction of another state, or shall require the members to submit such matters to settlement under the present charter. But this principle shall not preclude the application of enforcement measures under Chapter 7. One way to reason this through is that the UN system itself is based on the notion of sovereign equality of all member states as guaranteed in Article 2.1 of the UN Charter. The organization is based on the principle of the sovereign equality of all its members. And so within this normative order, it is sacrosanct that all countries are equal. As such, every nation state's political independence is to be respected and should be free from interference and allowed to run its internal politics as it deems fit, with the caveat that the nation state respects human rights of its citizens. And so we see that the principle of territorial integrity and sovereignty is so foundational to interstate relations and indeed the domain of international law that many intergovernmental organizations have firmly entrenched this principle in their constitutive charter. For example, though not legally binding, the Helsinki Final Act of the Organization for Security and Cooperation, which is the world's largest security-oriented intergovernmental organization, has recognized the sovereign equality of all its state parties, as well as the inviolability of frontiers and territorial integrity of all its nation states. Also, the Charter of the Organization of the African Union, the OAU, also enshrines the principle of sovereignty and territorial integrity of its members. In essence, we see that as a consequence of the equality among states and sovereignty, these sources entrench within their constitutive instruments the supreme authority that states have within their territory and freedom from externality, including the immunity from jurisdiction of other states and intervention on their territory. What consequence does this carry on the international law? We have talked extensively about the fact that international law is largely a system based on rights, obligations, and duties. This also applies to the concept of sovereignty. So, sovereign states have the following rights: non-interference, legality of sovereign acts, constitutional and organizational autonomy. When and where any of these rights are breached by any organ of another sovereign state, the affected state has a right to bring claims for internationally wrongful acts. Sovereign states also have corresponding duties: the duty to hold other states immune from its jurisdiction, duty to cooperate and respect international law, prohibition of intervention of other sovereign states, and duty of peaceful settlement of disputes. Just to recap, in this lecture, we have shown that historically the concept of sovereignty was seen in three ways. So there were three variations. But specific to this lecture, we narrowed it down to the nature and the source of sovereignty. We have also talked about the immutable characteristics of territorial sovereignty or integrity. We have also established that the concept of territorial sovereignty takes its roots in customary international law and has taken a hold in the Charter of the United Nations. We also stated that the constitutive instruments of many intergovernmental organizations have entrenched the concept of territorial sovereignty or integrity. And we gave two examples of such intergovernmental organizations. Also, we talked about the concept of territorial integrity And the fact that it donates rights to sovereign states and creates corresponding obligations. In all, I just want to say thank you so very much for joining in. And remember to like, share, and subscribe. Also, hit the notification button so that you're notified when there's a new video. Thank you.